What's up, people? Welcome to the session. How are you guys doing? As always, welcome to the session. My name is Anup and we are back with the VIP series, guys. Today we'll be doing one of the most easiest chapter there is in physics. On top of that, they've reduced the syllabus so much that it is, you know, almost like it's probably one of the most easiest chapter, not probably, it is one of the most easiest chapter that you're ever gonna have. And that is nothing but the human eye and the colorful world. Today we'll be talking about, we'll be solving some questions based on from this chapter, taken from this chapter. Again, it's a series, so we'll be having a lot more to come in the sessions ahead. Today we'll be talking about dispersion of light. So this is the topic that we're gonna talk about. Now, for all those who are new to the VIP series, VIP stands for very important problems where we'll try to solve the most important questions that can be possibly asked from that particular topic. And today's topic is dispersion of light. So based on this topic, we'll be solving about 9 to 10 questions and all the questions taken from the same exact topic. And now what I want you to do is solve the questions with me, and more importantly, be true to yourself. So whatever answer you give, cross-check that answer, but more importantly, be true to yourself. It's okay, there's no marks as such, but it's important that you do that so that you get an idea of where you're going wrong, so you can correct it before your finals, right? So that's it, people. Let's begin the very first question for today. Back-to-back questions. Now, what I want you guys to do is, if you need a little bit more time to read the question, just pause the video and then try to read the question and then try to solve it by yourself. But whatever it is, the first question is this, guys. The colored light that refracts the most while passing through a prism is which of these? Yellow, violet, blue, or red? So if you have a prism, guys, you know that white light basically splits into the seven prominent colors that we have, which is nothing but WebGL. So basically, what does it look like? This is what it basically looks like. This is what the the pattern of the different colors of light actually diffracts into. So you see this, that among all the colors, the red is the one that refracts the least. Violet, on the other hand, is the one that refracts the most, and it'll always be towards the base of the prism. I want you guys to remember that, because we'll be solving a lot more questions based on that. So yes, guys, violet is the right answer for this question. Quite an easy one. I know that you guys already know this, but still, for sake of explanation. Second question. The effect of glass prism is only to separate the seven colors of what? White light, light from the bulb, sunlight, or all of these? The effect of glass prism is only to separate the seven colors of, generally we use white light for it, we don't use light from the bulb, even sunlight could be an answer, but white light or sunlight is the possible answers, right? Because you see that, because white light is a combination of seven different colors, and that is how you're able to see those seven prominent colors. So white light or sunlight, any of these could be the possible answer for that. Again, sunlight is also nothing but white light itself, so you can say that white light is the right answer, right? Moving on to the next question, that's another easy one. So white light is the answer, because white light is a combination of seven different colors. And why does it look white? Because all those colors are moving at, all those wavelengths of light are moving at such high velocity that for a person who's seeing it, it appears as though it's white, right? Newton's disc, remember. Next one, based on the same thing. When Newton's color disc is rotated fast, the different colors can be separated, can be differentiated, cannot be differentiated, or both can be separated and as well as can be differentiated. You know the answer for this question, guys. So you know what Newton's disc is, right? So you take a disc, you divide it into seven equal halves and color them with WebGR, violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, and orange and red. So what happens is that when you start rotating it really, really fast, what happens is that, guys, it appears as though it's white. So what happens is that you're not able to differentiate when it starts to rotate fast. That is what, that simple explanation is what explains this particular question also, that white light is actually a combination of seven different colors. And that's how Newton exactly proved it. So the answer is cannot be differentiated. Such easy questions, guys. Again, one of the most easiest chapter. If you just go through the textbook once or twice, this chapter, it's going to be super duper easy. Next one. At a particular minimum value of angle of deviation, the refracted ray becomes parallel to the base of the prism, perpendicular to the base of the prism, inclined at 45 degrees with respect to the base of the prism. At a particular, if the angle of deviation is minimum, then the refracted ray is going to be parallel to the base of the prism. So imagine this, if this is the incident ray and the angle of deviation is a bare minimum, then the ray of light that gets refracted would actually be parallel to the base of the prism. So the answer to this question, guys, is actually option number A. Not perpendicular, it'll not be inclined as well. It's going to be parallel to the base of the prism. Yet another easy question. Now, again, I'm going a little too fast because you know the answers for this question. Now, if you want more time to resolve these questions, as always, pause the video, solve the question, and then cross-check if you got the right answer or not. Okay, that's the best way to go about it, right? Moving on to the fifth question, guys. We are pretty much halfway through, more than halfway through, in fact. Here's another one, the fifth question. A student traces the path of a ray through a glass prism for four different values of angle of incidence. On analyzing the diagram, he is likely to conclude that the emergent ray is always parallel to the incident ray, is always perpendicular to the incident ray, is always parallel to the refracted ray, always bends at an angle direction of the incident ray. All right. A student traces the path of a ray through a glass prism for four different values of angle of incidences. All right. So you have a prism. There are four different values of angle of incidences. So imagine these are the four values. Okay, my diagram skills are superbly bad, but you get the idea. People imagine that they're all on the same point and that this is the normal to that surface, right? So yeah, the question is, on analyzing the diagrams, what is he more likely to conclude about the emergent ray? It's always parallel to the incident ray? Definitely not. Is always perpendicular to the incident ray? No. Is always parallel to the refracted ray? Again, no. So what should be the answer then? Always bends at an angle to the direction of the incident ray. That is, if you change the angle of incidence, the angle of emergence would also change accordingly. In other words, that is all they are trying to convey over here. So when you change the angle of incidence, the angle of emergent will also change, which means the angle of deviation would also change in that particular case. That's it. Simple. This is the answer for that question, people. So yes, that is the answer. Moving on to the sixth question, people. Here's another one. Super duper easy. The question is this. While performing the experiment to trace the path of a ray of light passing through a glass prism, four students mark the incident ray and the emergent ray in their diagrams in the manner shown below. The correct path of the ray has to be shown by what? One, two, three, or four, guys. Look at that. First of all, the refracted ray should, okay, because you can see that the angle of deviation is minimum. You can see that it's going to be parallel to the base. That's one thing that you can conclude. But it's always going to be towards the base of the prism. So you cannot say that this is correct. Here, there's no refraction whatsoever happening. And it's very clear that the ray of light, the incident ray, is not normal to the surface. So that is also not right. Third could be the possible right answer. Because again, the emergent ray will, because it's going from a denser medium into a rarer medium, if this is the normal, if I were to draw, this is the normal. Because it's going from denser medium to rarer medium, it has to go away from the normal, right? And here you can see that it's going towards the normal, and hence option number C, or the third one, is definitely the right answer, because you can see that it's moving towards the base. Again, the emergent ray is again going towards the base itself, and so the right answer is option number 3. Right, guys, if you are enjoying the session so far, if you are able to solve all these questions awesomely well, and people hit that like button, show some love, show some. Yeah, love is more than enough, huh? Show some love, show some support. Hit that subscribe button. Also, click on the bell icon, guys. And if you want to learn these kind of topics in detail in every single session that you have ahead, click on the link that is given in the description and enroll into the Vedantu Pro subscription course right now. Let me tell you what are the advantages very quickly, guys. First of all, you have unlimited number of sessions, and every single session will have quizzes, and you'll also have a lot of fun as well. And these quizzes will also give you an opportunity to compete with the rest of the world and see how good you are in that particular topic. You can understand your weaknesses, you can understand your strength just by analyzing how or what type of answers you're giving in the quiz questions. And yes, all of the sessions are recorded, and every single recordings are such a way that even while watching the replays, you can take the quizzes and check out the leaderboard. So you never miss out on anything that is important. And yes, all the notes and every single content that you see on the screen can be downloaded. It can be referred. You can download it as a PDF and refer to it how many of a number of times you want. With all of these, this is probably the best part, which is going to blow your mind off, that every single session will not just have the master teacher, but together with the master teacher, you'll also have the class teacher who will help you clear every single doubt of yours. And yes, you'll have tests and assignments as well. And these tests and assignments are planned and designed such a way that it's definitely is going to give you an edge in your exams, in your exam preparations, so that you can do better, much, much better in your boards. And with all of these, you have 5,000 plus micro courses and crash courses. So what are you supposed to do? Click on the link that is given in the description just to give you a quick look into what it looks like, guys. So imagine this is one of the videos that's already uploaded.
Let the ad go off first. 1 second, guys. Yes, skip the ad.
So what do you do is, guys, click on the description. I'll just show you. Click on as you guys are already watching the video right now, just click on the description and click on subscribe to Vedanta Pro right now. Click on the link and enroll into the courses. So if you are someone who's moving from 9th to 10th, then click on 10th grade, and then from there go to CBSE 2022. If you're already in 10th grade, then go to CBSE 2021, because you're going to give your exams right now, right? You're going to give all the revision, every single thing that is needed, exam prep, everything that is there is going to be added over here. And if you go for the 1 month program, guys, that's 1,500 rupees for 1 month. But if you click on proceed to pay, the discount code is already added to it. So that means that you'll have to pay just 1,200 rupees. How cool is that, right? 1,200 rupees with the best of the best teachers on the best of the best online platform. Now, if you're someone who's going from 9th over to 10th standard, you have to go to CBSE 2022. And here again, if you go for the 1 month program, that's 3,300 rupees. But again, if you click on the link, a discount code is already added. So that's 2,640 rupees. Just to give you a rough idea, guys, if you think about the value for money that you're going to get for all of these sessions. So if you go for the 1 month program, which I would suggest you to go for, you're paying about 6 rupees per session, because in that 1 month duration, you'd have attended at least a minimum of 200 sessions. And if you're someone who's going from 9th to 10th standard, then it's CBSE 2022. That means that per session, you're paying roughly about 13.2 rupees. Now, if you go for the year-long program, that is the whole year program, that is till 2022 March, that's about 38,880 rupees. But again, once you click on the link, the coupon code is already applied. So the price drops down to 31,104 rupees, which means that you're getting a discount of about 7,000 rupees. And then if you think about the value for money, you're paying about 12.96 rupees per session, which again, if you think about it, is less than a packet of rice or kurkure. Yeah. Link in the description, enroll right now. With that said, people, moving on to the last couple of quiz questions. Here's another one. In the following diagram, the path of a ray of light passing through a glass prism is shown. In this diagram, the angle of incidence, the angle of emergence, and the angle of deviation respectively are such an easy question. They're asking you which is the angle of incidence, which is the angle of emergence, which is the angle of deviation. That's all. So first of all, guys, angle of incidence in this case is nothing but y, right? This is the angle of incidence. This is the normal, this is the incident ray. The angle from between the normal and the incident ray is the angle of incidence. So that is the angle of incidence. Now, what is the emergent ray? Q would be the emergent ray, because you can see that is the emergent ray and that's the normal. So the angle formed, the angle of emergence would be Q. Now to talk about what is the angle of deviation, that's nothing but P, right? Angle of deviation is nothing but P. So deviation is nothing but P. So the answer is YQ and P, if I'm not wrong. YQ and P. That's all, people. Option number 4, right? Not option number 3, it's option number 4. Right, guys? So that is the answer for that question. Such an easy question. Listen, it cannot get any more easier than this. I mean, come on, you guys are 10th standard. I am pretty sure that every one of you guys would have got this right, and I hope that this question appears in your board exams as well. It's like that'll be a dream come true. All right, eighth and the last and the final question for today, guys. A prism ABC with BC as base is placed in different orientation. A narrow beam of white light is incident on the prism as shown in the figure given below. In which of the following cases, after dispersion, the third color from the top corresponds to the color of the sky? Which of these cases, the third color from the top corresponds to the color of the sky? So what is the color of the sky? It's blue, right? Now, for the first one, what's going to happen is that after after the dispersion would look something like this. which is nothing but your web geol. It'll be like this, right? Because again, violet is always towards the base of the prism. So web geol. So the third color from the top is nothing but green over here, which is not, which they are asking for blue, right? Now for this one again, what will, again, towards the base of the prism. So seven prominent colors, that will be web geol. So what is the third prominent color? It's nothing but blue. And that would be the right answer. But if you want to talk about this one as well, again, towards the base of the prism. So yes, again, this will also be red on top and violet at the bottom. And this one again, yes, so imagine this is the base of the prism. So again, this will be red on top and violet at the base. So option number two, or the second diagram, would be the right answer for this question.
That's all. That's all, people. That's all.
That is all for today, people. That is all for today. So that is the answer for this question. And with that, this is your homework. Let me know what is the answer in the comment section, guys. The question is this. The angle at which the ray gets deviated is called as what? The angle at which the ray gets deviated is called as what? Let me know what is the answer in the comment section. Thanks a lot for joining. And do not forget to enroll into the what revolution that is going on right now, people. And I'm pretty sure that a lot of you guys already know about it. And the exam that's going to happen, what stands for Vedantu Online Talent Examination, which is going to go on from 28th of March. That means that the first one is already done. 4th of April, 11th of April, and 18th of April. So the time is still not done. You still have an opportunity to get a scholarship from a pool of 500 crores, guaranteed scholarship with in-depth performance analysis and exciting prizes to be won worth 1 crore. And the main winners would be getting a chance to be the CEO of Vedantu for one whole day. And also would be getting, other people would also be getting a trip to NASA in the United States of America. Lots and lots of amazing prizes, from smartwatches to Alexa to your VR goggles to a ton of amazing prizes are waiting for you guys. So what you do is click on the link that is given in the description. You can also see the link that is there in the top. So click on that link, just copy that link, take a screenshot, register to the vote. You'll get a voter ID. Once you get the voter ID, select which of the dates you are comfortable in taking the exam. So this is what the exam pattern looks like. So you have MAT as well as SAT. So you'll have aptitude based questions as well as subject related questions as well. 35 questions of each. Each question carries 4 marks, and you'll be having -1 mark as well. In total of 90 minutes, that's one hour, 30 minutes is what you have. 1.5 hour time off any of the Sundays that you're comfortable with. You can also create squads, a squad of 4 people, and you can solve the questions among the squad and get some exciting prizes on that as well. So that's it for today, people. I'll catch you guys in the next episode of Human Eye and Colorful World. We'll be talking about atmospheric refraction then. So see you then. All the very best for your exams. Good luck for your preparations. I hope that all of you guys are taking care of yourself. And yes, that's it for now. Thank you for joining, guys. See you all soon. Do not forget to subscribe. Do not forget to like the video and enjoy yourself.